Let's talk about how real numbers are stored in computer memory. Okay, so if we are given some number chi, which is a real valued number, then we can think of that number as being plus or minus some mantissa times beta to the e, where beta is the base that we use. We typically use 2 because we store in computer memory and it stores bits. So the problem is that we can only use a finite number of bits to store our real number. And you know, typically people use 32 bits if it's single precision, 64 bits if it's double precision. And then you need to decide, how do we use these bits that are at our disposal? Well, either implicitly or explicitly, we need 1 bit to indicate the sign. We then take a certain number of bits to indicate the exponent, the integer that represents the exponent. And then we're left with a certain number of bits. In our case, we're going to say we have t bits left to store the mantissa. So in a typical situation, a number, chi check, is in the set of floating point numbers in a particular situation. When the base that we use is equal to 2, we're storing binary numbers, we then end up with t binary digits that are stored. Those digits can be 0 or 1, so they're bits. And we normalize it so that the first binary digit is equal to 0 if and only if the real number that we're trying to store is 0. Okay. And finally, because we have a finite number of bits to store the exponent, there is a smallest exponent that we can store, and there is a largest exponent that we can store. And what that means is that there are numbers that in magnitude are too large to store. We call it overflow. And typically those are then stored as a special number that represents not a number. And there are numbers that are in magnitude too small to store. And those numbers typically are rounded down to 0, although sometimes you can control that. So the whole point of numerical analysis in this course is to examine how the limitations of only being able to store floating point numbers translates into the accuracy or lack of accuracy in our algorithms.